people get a lot of confusion because they keep trying to think quantum mechanics as classical mechanics. This was something which an American physicist, Coleman Sidney, said. So have your minds prepared for some counterintuitive things coming the way. This is my favorite pen. All the colors together in a single pen. Cool, right? But wait, what if I told you this is the way every quantum object behaves in this universe? Yeah, you heard me right. Confused? No worries. Let's take this hydrogen atom. This one electron orbits the nucleus by revolving around it, but it looks like electron is everywhere in surrounding space. That's a wave, certainly. We have another example. The famous Young's double slit experiment. This experiment basically demonstrates the constructive and destructive interference of light. The light is thrown on these surfaces with two slits of width narrower than the wavelength of light. So, light gets diffracted and form interference patterns on the behind screen, illuminated screen. The dark region is of complete destructive interference separated by the high intensity corresponding to regions of constructive interference. To be concise, this is all caused by superposition of overlapping of light waves originating from the two slits. Now notice, instead of two slits, if we had one, then there would be no interference. Hence, light would be a particle in this case.
No, that's not true. According to Huygens' principle, every point on a wavefront can be considered as a source of other waves or the secondary waves, just like these. And we need not discuss it right now, as it doesn't have anything to do with understanding our main topics.
So every teeny tiny quantum object is having this behavior, huh? Well, yeah, the quantum phenomenon, which is a consequence of dual particle and wave nature of everything, is called superposition. Here's a fun fact. In quantum computing, which is using applications of quantum mechanics through complex computer systems, at least that's how I define it, the qubits can be superpositioned on purpose experimentally. Qubits are basically the basic units of quantum information. So why is it that sometimes light behaves as a particle and sometimes as a wave? Actually, the problem is very similar to Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. The position and momentum of an object cannot be measured both at the same time. Here, object in superposition, when measured or observed, collapses into any single state. This is called a wave function collapse. So after wave function collapse, the probability of all the states is equal. So now we can conclude that objects at a quantum level tends to be in superposition state unless and until measured. I wish I was a quantum object or a qubit, because then if I was that, I could be happy at the same time.